Hey guys, today we are going to be doing how to behave at a tea party. How many of you guys have had a tea party before? We haven't, but I just brought Brooklyn a tea set for her birthday, so we'll have to do one. First, we're going to open the invitation. Then you scrub your left elbow and your right knee. Don't forget the ears, Charles, or the nose. They're scrubbing the doggy, I think. And she's getting ready, watching her elbows over there. Next, you're going to put on some fancy clothes and wear a fancy hat. Underwear, it does not count as a hat. We actually have a really cute picture of our bulldog wearing underwear on his head. If you guys want to check it out, it's Gizmo Garland, hashtag Frenchies of Instagram. There's a lot of really cute pictures of him online, so check it out. Help me put on the tablecloth and some fresh panonis. Do not invite the McCargan brothers or the frog. Look at them. It looks like those McCargan brothers are troublemakers, and she doesn't want them invited because she doesn't want them to cause any trouble there. Leave the snake in your room, Charles. You may bring a stuffed animal and a present. Do not eat the panonis or the tablecloth. You must take deep breaths and count to seven. I will do all of the pouring. You will hold the teacup nicely by the handle like this. I just want to see how to hold it. She's holding it so nice and gentle. We will eat tiny sponge cakes with raspberry jam and sandwiches that are cut out with a cookie cutter. Except for Rexy, you may bring your own little bone. You must say please and thank you. You must not sip like a moose or bump like Uncle Victor. You must take deeper breaths and count to 382. Looks like she's getting frustrated over there. You can't build a rocket out of sugar cubes. Do not tie Barry to the chair. No towers out of teacups, Charles. But frogs don't even like tea. Towers shouldn't. Uh-oh, they're stacking cups. Uh-oh. Everything came tumbling down. No little brothers at this tea party. No dogs, no frogs, and no anybody. Aw, she's getting so upset. Poor thing. Now she's putting it all back together. Poor little lady. If you want to have a proper tea party, you must re-invite the guests. All right, go ahead. Bring the McCargan brothers. Of course you're invited, Rexy. You too, Frog. I suppose we could bring a rocket ship and you guys can build it out of sugar cubes. Maybe we could make a castle and a dragon and a moat. You may juggle the saucers if you want to, Charles, and rest a spoon on your nose. You may turn the napkin into a dinosaur and the tablecloth into a cape. If it's high tea, you must drink it at the top of the tippy-tippy top of the fort. And you must give me a hug and say... Oh, Julia, you throw the best tea parties. That was really cute. So sometimes when we want to do something and we plan something and it doesn't go the way that we wanted it to, we can't get upset. We just have to keep trying and we have to brush it off and we have to start over. We'll first take a deep breath and start all over again. And just be positive and make the best out of it. And sometimes when people come around, you don't always get along and things don't always go as planned, but you just have to make the best of it and just always keep smiling and be happy.